Praise the Lord and welcome to this abiding in the Lord through the word from John 15 verses 3 to 8. And we read, the Bible says that you're already clean because of the word I've spoken to you. Remain in me and I will remain in you. No branch can bear fruit by itself. It must remain in the vine. Neither can you bear fruit unless you remain in me. I am the vine, you are the branches. If a man remains in me and I in him, he will bear much fruit. Apart from me, you can do nothing. If anyone does not remain in me, he is like a branch that is thrown down and withers. Such branches are picked up and thrown in the fire and burnt. If you remain in me and my words remain in you, ask whatever you wish and it will be given you. This is to my Father's glory, that you bear much fruit, showing yourselves to be my disciples. Let us pray. Our Father and our God, we thank you for this opportunity that you've given unto us. As we hear your word, O Lord, we pray that you may cleanse our hearts, and my Father, my God, that you may speak to us in all that we are and in all that we do. For this we pray in Jesus' name. The Bible says that in the book of John, chapter 1 and verse 1, it says that in the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. And the Word became flesh and dwelt amongst men. Jesus Christ is the Word. It is one of the so many I ams in the Bible. In fact, the book of John, it talks about 8 I ams, as stated in Exodus chapter 3. And the first part, verse 3, it says that you're already clean because of the word I've spoken to you. In Psalms 119, verses 9 to 11, it says, how can a young man keep his ways pure? It's by guarding his ways according to your word. So the word cleanses us. The word washes us in our walk, in our talk. The word purifies us. In Ephesians chapter 5, verses 26, it says that he might sanctify and cleanse it with the washing of water by the word. This talks about the church of God, the bride of Christ. It talks about us remaining in him and he remaining in us. That no branch can bear fruit by itself. It must remain in the vine. Neither can you bear fruit unless you remain in me. When we abide in Christ, as a branch cannot bear fruit of itself, we are called as young men and women to remain in Christ, to walk together with Christ, to know, to stay attached to the tree itself, and through it all that you're going to bear fruits. The Bible says in Luke chapter 3 and verse 8 that we produce fruit in keeping with repentance. That is what John the Baptist said to the people who came to question him about him being Christ. And he said, I'm not Christ. Verse 5, it says, I'm the vine, you're the branches. If a man remains in me and I in him, he will bear much fruit. Apart from me, you can do nothing. And in our walk as Christians, as young men and women, we ought to know and realize that we can do nothing apart from Christ, that we cannot pull through life without him. We need him every aspect of the way. We need him so that he may guide us. We need him for sense of direction. We need him for clarity of mind. We need him in every aspect of the way, that whatever we do, we need his presence to walk with us. You know, Moses said in Exodus chapter 33 and verse 15 that if you're not going to go with us, do not take us from this place. And that is so huge for us, that we need Christ in every aspect of the way. It doesn't matter what the devil says, that we don't need Christ, but we need him for our own growth. Verse 6, it says, if anyone does not remain in me, he's like a branch that is thrown away and with us. Such branches are picked up, thrown into the fire and burnt. You see, the vines are so brittle, they cannot be used for timber or for building. So when the vines are withered, the only thing they can do is just pick them up, throw them into the furnace, and then they are burnt. And many are the times when we move away from Christ and we stop bearing fruit fruit that befits repentance, and it is our call and our duty to remain in Christ, remain attached in Him, and walk every step of the way with Him. Verse 7, it says, "If you remain in me and my words remain in you, ask whatever you wish and it will be given unto you." When Christ was saying these words, He said that if you remain in me and my words remain in you, ask whatever you wish and it will be given you. And that is our prayer, that every time we call to God, every time we come to Christ, you know, seeking whatever desire we have in our hearts, that He is ready to hear us. He is ready to come through. He is ready to answer us. You know, ours is to just call unto Him, seek Him in prayer, seek Him in the Word. You know, the Bible says that His words in Jeremiah chapter 15 and verse 16, it says, "Your words were found and I ate them, and they became a joy and a delight in my heart." So the Word has so much power. It is able to transform us. It is able to change us. As we've said, it is able to cleanse us, to wash us, to purify us. You know, Colossians chapter 3 and verse 16 says, "Let the word of Christ richly dwell in you, in our hearts as young men and women." We need the word of God every step of the way. You know, the psalmist said that your word is a lamp to my feet and a light to my path. And that is why he was able to become a friend of God. The Bible says in Acts chapter 13 and verse 22, that I have found a man after my own heart. God is so confident in him because David knew how to go back to God in the Word, to go back to God in prayer. And even as we are praying and fasting, it is my desire, even as we sang in Sunday school, that read your Bible, pray every day if you want to grow. And I believe that is the prayer of each and every one of us, that we want to grow, we want to become better, we want to grow our spiritual muscles, you know, stop feeding on the elementary foods, but now start feeding on the strong foods, you know, the hard foods of the Word of God. You know, the Bible says that many of us ought to be teachers, but it is not so because we are still feeding on the elementary parts, our foods of, you know, the Word of God. And this is to my Father's glory, that you bear much fruit, showing yourselves to be my disciples. The Word says that you will know the truth, and the truth shall set you free, and you truly become my disciples. And that is the desire that the Lord has for us, that we become his disciples in every manner of the way. As we walk, you know, our journey of faith, and even this life that God has given unto us, in our spheres of influence, we ought to have the Word of God in us, richly dwelling in us, you know, to impact those around us and even to impact ourselves, that that Word shall transform us, that Word shall become, you know, our shield, our buckler, our stronghold, that the Word of the Lord, the name of the Lord is a strong tower, that the righteous run into it and they are safe. And running to God is where we are most safe, and we can, you know, accomplish that which we purpose to accomplish in this life. And let us pray.
Thy word is a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my path. Thy word is a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my path. When I feel afraid, think I've lost my way, you're there right beside me. Nothing will I fear as long as you are near. Please be near me to the end.
Our Father and our God, we want to thank you for your word. Just as you're calling us, oh God, to abide in your word, oh dear Father, we pray that as we are going through the 21 days of prayer and fasting, that you may minister to us, O God, that you may speak to us, O God, every aspect of the way we need you. We need your presence to walk with us. We need your grace, O dear Father, that has been sufficient, O dear Lord. We need to see your faithfulness, O God, even as we present our prayers and our petitions, O God, not on the ground of righteousness, but on the ground of the great mercy, O my Father. We know that you're ready, O God, and willing to hear us, O God, and ready to transform us, and ready to change us, O dear Father. Many of us, O God, are wondering, I've never fasted, O dear Father, but how am I able to do this? Father, we pray that your presence is going to walk with each and every one of them, O dear Father, telling them, O God, and showing them the way, that this is the way, walk ye in it, O dear Father. We pray, dear Lord, every desire that has been presented unto you, O dear Father, you know, the few days that we've been in prayer and fasting, O God, we pray that you shall come through for your sons. You shall come through for your daughters, O dear Father. As we dedicate them, O God, unto your able hands, O God, those who are in school and those who are working, O dear Father, we commit them unto your presence, O God, that you may minister to them, minister to their hearts, minister to their souls, minister, O God, in their schools, in their places of work, O dear Father, minister in their families, O dear Father, in their spheres of influence, O God. May you make them, O God, agents of change, O dear Father. May you transform the worlds, O God, that they are living in, O dear Father. May you transform their talk, O God. May you transform, O my Father, their conducts, O dear Father, and help them, O God, to live and serve you, O dear Father, as they dwell, O my Father, in your word, as they stir, O God, into the deep, O God. May you speak to them, may you hear them, may you bless them, may you walk with them every step of the way. For this is our prayer we pray in Jesus' name. Amen.
Is a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my path. Thy word is a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my path. When I feel afraid, think I've lost my way, still you're there. Beside me, nothing will I.